Everybody, I'm back again. It is Thursday, and this may be my last day for a while until I can find a place where I can record where I won't be interrupted. It seems like I'm always like in here in the kitchen or over there at the table, and it's a main thoroughfare. You know, my husband's always coming in, getting a drink, getting this, getting that. And getting a snack. He's a compulsive snacker. And interrupting, you know, it interrupts me. And I lose my train of thought, which is very easy for me to do. So I need to find a place where I can, probably upstairs in one of the bedrooms. I should go up there. And then I can shut the door and I won't be interrupted. Anyway, he's on his way home. So he should be home. It's at almost 2 o'clock. He should be home probably in another hour or so. So, my free time. I racked my brain trying to figure out what to cook for dinner tonight. I thought, well, okay, I'll have ribbons, or I'll have the leftover spaghetti sauce that we had, that I saw a big container of it in the freezer. Okay, we'll have that. So I look in the cabinet. All the spaghetti is gone, the spaghetti noodles. He took them on the trip. And I go and check in the freezer out in the garage. We have an extra freezer out there. And the spaghetti sauce is gone. Do you see a theme going here? I went for my Ford Hook lima beans, couldn't find them. I went for my beets, couldn't find them. Everything is gone. So I decided, okay, well, you know, my older son is coming. He'll be here to pick up Lawrence. And so I said, are you going to stay for dinner? So I'm trying to figure out something that will feed a lot. So then I took out some steaks. I figured, well, he can grill some steaks. So my son doesn't necessarily like steak, but I figured, okay, we'll have steak. And then, you know, he says, well, I said, well, I can make red beans and rice. You know, I don't have enough pickle pork for it. I only have one package of it. But I could add some country ribs meat to it, you know. What do you think about that? And he before I could even send that text to him, he had already said no, he wasn't going to stay for dinner. So I put that back, got the steaks back out. Then I decided, you know, I'm going to have the red beans and rice anyway. I'll just use more sausage. So I just in case, because, you know, he may stay for dinner. So I put the steaks back, got the red beans, get the sausage and the pickled pork out. If you don't know what pickled pork is, it's a seasoned pork. It's kind of like corned beef, but not better. I can only buy it in Louisiana. That's the only place I've ever seen it. So a lot of times when I'm traveling through, I'll stop and pick up a bunch if we're in the RV. But we don't normally stop, so I'm on my last package of it. Anyway, I'm just going to add extra sausage to it, and decided I had that. So I've got my red beans on, and they have to cook for a couple hours before I add all the meat and stuff. So that'll be good for dinner tonight, and it'll feed an army if he happens to stay. So anyway, and I usually have cornbread with that, and that's about it. It's really, really good. You have it over rice. It's so good. Anyway, thought I'd show you my projects. I haven't gotten very far. Remember I said I was a slow knitter? Well, here's that washcloth. I'm only like, I don't know, a little more than halfway done. What do you think? You know, it's not too bad. It's turning out okay. It's still bigger than what I think it should be, but it'll be okay. So that's that. I love the colors in it. I love the colors. I'm curious to see what this would look like if I crocheted it, because I think crocheting would make a whole different pattern with it. So anyway, so that's the dishcloth and the baby blanket. I you know, it's gonna go slow. Here it is, and I think I'm liking it now. You know, I think it's gonna be nice. I did about 8 rows on this last night, and it doesn't look like I made very much progress, but 8 rows. It looks like it's going to stripe almost, except like this pink stripe ends right here, and then it's down lower here. So sort of striping, but not, you know. Anyway, I don't know. I think it's going to be pretty. So As you can see, my needles are snug. I mean, my yarn is snug on the needle. You're just seeing it on the cord where it looks real loose, but my stitches are kind of snug. So I'm not that loose of a knitter. Anyway, I think it's turning out nice. And it's going to be a lot nicer than I thought it was going to be originally. So I'm going to just continue with it, get finished, throw it in a washer and dryer, and see how soft and cuddly it is. And, and I can always make another one later. So that's my two projects. I'm really anxious to start on some socks. I'm going to do with two circular needles, and I'm going to do toe up. There's a really easy cast on that I'm going to use. It's called a Turkish cast on. You just wrap your yarn around the needles. How easy is that for a toe up? Simple. So the hardest part is just deciding which sock yarn to use. So I think I'm going to use one of that trench coat, that browns, the colors, the brown colors with the burgundy. That came with two little skeins of it, and I'm going to wind them today, and I think I'm going to start it with them. But it's hard trying to choose. I have so many sock yarns and so many great ones, and it's hard trying to choose which one to use. But I need to get myself a big bookcase with bins in it, with maybe a glass front or something that I can put all my yarn in facing out so I can see what I have. Because right now I have it in these plastic drawer things that I bought at Walmart because I didn't have any place else to put my yarn. And they're just stacked. They're just in my bedroom against a wall. And they're jam-packed. They're stuffed in there. And my husband says, why do you keep buying yarn? You have a whole thing full of it. I said, I don't even know what's in there. You know, it's hard to see it. If I had a bookcase or some kind of a cabinet, I could see it and I could go right up and say, oh, I like that yarn. I think I'll make something with that next. But I don't, so that's on my list, at the top of my list of things to do. So we'll see. Anyway, that's about it for this Thursday. I got to quick eat some lunch because it's already, like I said, it's already 2:00. And Lawrence will be here soon. And he'll probably want to go swimming, so I'll have to sit outside on the patio in the heat. It's so hot out. But it's a little overcast today, so it might not be too bad. Usually up here on the patio, rather than down at the pool, it goes down a little bit. It's a little bit cooler sometimes. It's always shaded there anyway, so. Okay, well, there's the phone. So I'm going to go. Have a great day, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.